very good Thursday afternoon to you. Welcome to Afternoon Focus. I'm Julie Grant.
And I'm Scott Withers, sitting in for my really good friend, Rob Nelson. Thanks so much for joining us on this Thursday afternoon.
And thank you for covering for Rob. It's always good to have you here.
With you.
We love you here, my friend. You're busy over at Scripps News.
Yeah.
Folks can catch you every morning there.
Monday through Friday, 7 to 11 on Morning Rush.
And then moonlighting here on
Absolutely.
Afternoon
Focus. Absolutely. Getting my side hustle on.
That's right. That's right. Well, you know, we like to kick things off with the stories at the top of our feed, so here we go.
And an early contender for sweetest picture of the year, even though it's only, you know, January and the year just started.
Right. Take a look. This sweet diapered baby running toward her firefighter daddy, who was responding to an emergency call down the street from their house.
Look at her.
Once the situation was safe, her mom let her go and see her hero. The Glendale, Arizona Fire Department's post has gone viral, as you could imagine.
Oh, yeah.
And it's also given us a chance to really see what these brave men and women are risking when they run into danger to save other people.
And we don't really always realize, because we're in the middle of a disaster or a fire or something, and there's police officers or ambulance, you don't realize that they have the family at home. And, that's what they're going back to. So you really need to think about them and really just know how much they're putting on the line to protect all of us and keep us all safe.
Right. And heroic jobs like the jobs that firefighters have, police officers, it affects the whole family, everybody
sure
that loves them, because you never know what is going to happen on any given day. And they're signing up to take the danger, take the risk, take all of that for other people.
Yeah.
It's so noble. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. Well, switching gears a little bit, now we want to talk about a star whose career arc stretches from a Dunkin' Donuts in New York City to the highest grossing tour by a female artist. You guessed it, we're talking about Madonna. She's going out on the road again.
Tickets go on sale tomorrow for Madonna's global tour titled Celebration, in honor of the 40th anniversary of her first studio album. Now, the U.S. portion of the tour starts in July in Seattle, and it wraps up in Vegas the first weekend of October. So that's kind of pretty quickly. She's not wasting any time.
No. Okay, how much do you love Madonna? Are you a Madonna fan?
I am. Well, I grew up at that same kind of time when she was just, her career was exploding. Papa Don't Preach. I mean, Vogue, I could just go on and on about all of, and that's the issue. She's got such a huge library of songs. I don't know how she's going to fit into one concert, one night.
Oh, I know. She's iconic. No matter what you think about her, like, she is talented. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, there's no question about it. And she's really carved out a name for herself forever in music history.
And helped a lot of female musicians along the way. So it's good news. Good news for her, and good to enjoy that concert. Sometimes it takes a crisis for us to really see what's been right in front of our eyes, you know, the entire time. Such is the case for this heroic work nurse do on a daily basis.
Yeah, talking about heroes, nurses certainly are too. And their importance, I think, really came to the forefront during the pandemic, Scott? We talked a lot about it. And since we've kind of returned to a little bit of more of a sense of normalcy in America, some of the headlines we were seeing have kind of faded away.
But their work hasn't gotten any less stressful at all. And to help that, a hospital in Indiana has opened up a new way for them to relax using a centuries-old technique. Our friend Megan Shin has the story.
Sitting cross-legged on yoga mats, letting go of everything, focusing on your breath. It's a moment of tranquility. Something you usually see at a yoga studio instead of at a hospital.
And inhale, rise up, look up, smile, gratitude. Exhale.
John Shepherd.
Katie Lynn.
Is the man behind this free yoga class at IU Health Methodist Hospital.
They like it. More of it.
It started in early December with just three people participating. Now, there are nearly a dozen yoga nurses or doctors here every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Shepherd says he knows how invaluable this program is.
For 30 minutes, when I would get home, I would just kind of shut the door and just stretch out and breathe and just kind of reflect back on my day and check in to see how I'm doing.
He worked in the ICU for 14 years.
It probably extended my career by a couple of years in the ICU, because it is really hard work. And not just the ICU, but all of our nurses. Regardless of the setting, nursing's hard work, and you got to fill the cup if you want to provide the type of care we want to provide.
Just 1 hour of yoga at 7:45 p.m. taking care of the entire doctor or nurse who participates.
It's already here. You almost feel bad if you don't go. It just makes it easy. And yeah, if I leave here and I'm on my way home, I'm not likely to stop at the gym. I just go straight home anyway.
Caroline Cornette's worked as a registered nurse at IU Health for 4 years.
Makes me feel like there are people here that care about the nurse's well-being, like us as people.
It's mindfulness-based practices in a clinical setting, releasing the stress of those who help us heal and stay healthy.
Scotty, you were getting zen there.
I still am. Yeah. I might do some downward dog right now.
Do you do yoga?
I don't, but I really should. I have lots of friends that do it. I have a couple nurses in my family, my Aunt Vicky, my cousin Katie. They work really hard, and they did during the pandemic. And I know that they really need this kind to help de-stress because it was an extremely stressful situation for them.
Yeah, oh, most certainly. Yeah, anything that can bring down the stress level and just improve your overall health and mental wellness, I'm all for it.
Might have to try that out.
I do DDP yoga. Dallas Page's yoga, which is like not your mama's yoga.
Oh.
It's like push-ups and old school calisthenics.
Oh, yeah.
It's a workout. It's good stuff.
That's way too advanced for me.
Because he's the coolest, yeah.
I'm going to do the baby stops.
We got to get Dallas on Afternoon Focus.
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, well, it's time to get your popcorn ready right now as we bring you a few quick stories that are just fun to know. And we start with something that everybody has at least one of, and that is food in a tin can. On this day, back in 1835, Ezra Daggett and Thomas Kensett were given the U.S. patent for their method of, quote, preserving animal substances.
Ooh.
And it's fun to know that while we still call them tin cans, they're now mostly made of steel with just a thin coating of tin. Okay.
Interesting.
All right. So now you know, right?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Well, now we want to celebrate the birthday of a true queen.
A big one.
Stumble out of bed and stumble to the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch and try to come to life.
That's right, the iconic Dolly Parton turned 77 years young today. It's fun to know that recordings experts wanted Dolly to be a pop star, thinking her soprano voice was too high for country music. It's also fun to know she can play more than a half dozen instruments. I am not surprised.
She is so talented.
She can do everything.
She's a great songwriter, too.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't realize what a brilliant songwriter she is. And get this, the birthday girl has her name on a line of new baking mixes.
Mm.
They're for biscuits, cornbread, and two flavors of brownies, and Dolly says they're inspired by her family recipes. And if you'd like to try them out, they'll be hitting stores later on this month. Let's go, Scotty.
I'm going to definitely try some of those out
for the set here. Yeah.
Well, there is more positive news ahead coming up. When gnarly weather stranded a veteran, total strangers helped him get home.
I'm just glad to be home. I'm glad I have so many supporters that I didn't know about until my buddy called me and told me, "You're a star."
Welcome back. Northern Lights never get old. This one was captured in Fairbanks, Alaska by a self-described Aurora chaser who didn't have too much chasing to do this time around. He tweeted that he got out of his bed in his pajamas and threw on his boots before recording this wondrous scene that we're looking at outside of his home. Scotty, what do you think?
Spectacular. That's on my bucket list to go see the Aurora Borealis.
Oh, yeah.
It is spectacular. And now's the time of the year to do it right now. Yeah.
Good suggestion.
Absolutely.
Oh, well, you know weather so well, and, you know, traveling during the holiday season was quite the challenge, largely
Lots
because
of
weather.
Lost bags, cancellations, and delays were par for the course. But when strangers found out a 70-year-old Army veteran was stranded in an airport, well, they made it their mission to bring him home. Julie Dunmeyer is sharing the story from Grand Rapids, Michigan.
I am here meeting a total stranger, a person that I have never met.
This is Linda Ross.
We got a bag to carry everything in.
She comes bearing gifts.
So we had to get him a nice winter coat.
Because the stranger Linda's meeting has...
nothing. Nothing.
All this for the man, the stranger, she now considers a friend.
Because he's a vet. And he was treated horribly.
Now she waits for her new friend's flight, which is getting closer to the ground by the minute.
Hi, Harold.
Hi.
I am Linda. I am Jamie's friend.
Harold is back home, but getting here was the hard part.
They kept canceling.
You see, all of Harold's flights back to West Michigan from Vegas were canceled. Harold is moving back to Holland to live with a good friend. He ended up in Orlando, and those flights got canceled. The Army veteran, who served more than 30 months in Germany in the late 70s, spent 8 days without a bed, stranded.
It's not easy on a young guy, much longer, and then have to sleep on the floor.
Until he met a kind stranger, Jamie, in the Orlando airport, where Harold also spent his 70th birthday.
I love my friend Jamie to death. She is just no words to describe her. She is just a special person, and you will never meet another person like her. She wishes she could be here, but she's a teacher, and she had to teach.
Jamie, along with the help of dozens of others in Holland, like her friend Linda, made it their mission to get Harold home. They helped him rebook a flight. Harold couldn't do it himself, on his old flip phone.
I was telling my buddy, I says, if I could find the river, I'd catch a low flying mud turtle and ride his back.
This veteran, not used to the idea of local fame, but grateful for all of the people who came to help him. Harold, who says he's technically homeless, is finally on his way.
I'm just glad to be home. I'm glad I have so many supporters that I didn't know about until my buddy called me and told me, you're a star.
Wow. Oh, he must feel so loved. And the kindness then continued. Get this, an Allegiant employee drove Harold the distance from Grand Rapids to Holland, Michigan, where he was reunited with his friends and family. Scott, I know you love this.
Yeah, that's fantastic because it wasn't just the initial people that got him home, but for that Allegiant airline employee to really go the extra distance and get him to his home.
Right.
Because that's a big distance between Holland and Grand Rapids, so that's really nice of them to do that.
Oh, yeah. It's so selfless, right? Because everybody's busy, right?
Yep.
We all have things going on. We all have people in our lives that count on us and depend on us. But then to say, you know what? Let me just set all of my stuff aside and do something for somebody else.
It
is
just
really
makes you feel good about people.
The definition
it really does.
Of kindness.
Because sometimes it's easy to not feel good about people. So that makes you feel good about people. And we need more of that. We need a lot more of that.
We do. Absolutely. Sure do. That's why we do the show,
absolutely.
Folks.
Absolutely.
You know that. Don't go anywhere. When we come back, we'll introduce you to the internet's favorite talking dog who knows how to push all the right buttons.
Love the doggies.
I figured if I pressed the outside button every time we went outside and I said the word outside, she would make that connection. And she did. Within a few weeks, she was using it on her own to communicate to me that she wanted to go outside. And we've been growing our board ever since.
Yep, exactly. We're home now. Oh, I love you too, Bunny.
Oh, no need to adjust your TV screens. That dog was actually talking, folks. That sweet little girl is Bunny, the internet famous dog who's grown a massive social media
following. I see why.
Thanks to her uncanny ability to speak her thoughts, her feelings, even her dreams, Scott. And earlier this week, Rob and I caught up with Bunny's owner. Her name is Alexis Devine. Yeah. She told us the story of how she was able to create this way of communicating with Bunny. Take a look at what she shared. Okay, so first question, Alexis. So what inspired you to start communicating with Bunny?
Well, I hadn't had a dog since childhood, and I all of a sudden was ready to have a non-human animal in my life, and my goal was to have the best relationship possible with the best communication possible. And I had never trained a dog before, so I started researching training and dog behavior, and I came across Christina Hunger, who's a speech-language pathologist. She was using recordable buttons to teach her own dog, Stella, how to communicate with her. And I thought, what a brilliant way to increase your communication and your connection. So I had buttons waiting by the door for Bunny by the time she came home at 8 weeks old.
Do you need to go outside?
I figured if I pressed the outside button every time we went outside and I said the word outside, she would make that connection. And she did. Within a few weeks, she was using it on her own to communicate to me that she wanted to go outside. And we've been growing our board ever since.
You're right, Alexis. I feel like you're hitting the nail right on the head for all of us animal lovers. When it comes to like deciphering the different phrases that Bunny will put together for you, what's really key for that in you in kind of understanding her communication?
Like a mother and her toddler, like a mother sort of intrinsically understands what a toddler is trying to say if they babble enough in the same way day after day. some of Bunny's communications feel a lot like that. We're like, this is a pattern of words that she's used before to mean this specific thing. But my favorite interactions are the ones where I'm not even communicating with her or by the buttons at all, and she just goes over to the buttons to tell me, hey, look, there's a bird outside. Or for example, the other day, Otter was playing around and then he tripped and he hurt his paw and he lifted his paw, he was limping, and I went over to him and I was like, oh no, are you okay? And I was like stretching out his arm, and Bunny did this little stress shake and then walked over to her buttons and pressed paw, paw, because Otter was lifting his paw, and then went over to button board and pressed love you on it.
That is so cool, Alexis. Well, we wish you all the best. Would love to see Bunny before you go. Can we say hi to her? Would that be okay?
Yes, I'm going to take you.
Can Bunny say hi to her?
Walk over.
Yeah, can Bunny say hi?
I think that's the question.
Oh, look at Bunny.
Hey, Bunny.
Hi, Bunny. Oh, she's beautiful. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. She just wants to.
Alexis, what's she saying to us? Is she saying, we like those hosts on Afternoon Focus.
She's saying,
you are my new favorite people. Oh, and Otter doesn't want to be excluded.
Hi, Otter.
Oh, beautiful
Otter's
dogs.
Beautiful, too.
And wow. Beautiful minds, apparently. Wow.
Yeah, they are smart. Smart, smart.
Alexis, thanks so much for giving us some time. We really appreciate it. It's fascinating what you're up to. So come back when they start driving, and, we'll check back with you soon.
Thank you so much for having me. This has been great.
Oh my gosh. And wow. If you want to see the full interview with Alexis and Bunny, just head over to our Facebook page. And Scott, we've got the buttons here. Our incredible producer, Evan Torch, ordered these for us so that we could actually see what Bunny uses.
You go ahead and do it.
So, geez, I don't know. Let's see. We'll just tap this one.
Outside. All right, let's try this one.
Play.
My dog would be
play outside.
Now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. This is fantastic. I fell in love with those dogs. Beautiful. But just that they can really communicate. They were saying exactly what they wanted. Now they've been trained. I'm going to try this with my dog.
Will you? Do you think he'll be able to do it?
I don't know. His will just be play, play. Oh, yeah. And then we need one for feed me.
Oh, feed me. Oh, yeah. That's an important one. Yeah. Feed me, pet me, walk me,
yeah,
kiss
exactly.
me, love me. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I would love to see if my dog could do it. I know her and how she is. And she's so attached. Like, if you try to get her to do anything away from you, she won't do it. She likes just come and sit on your feet.
Okay.
So probably if I put the buttons in front of her, she would just like walk around them and just sit down.
I think you got to give it a try
and see if Raina can do it.
Yeah, I think I've seen these on various social media before, but I've never really seen the interview with someone and explained how they did it. Now that I know, it looks like you got to put a little work into it, a little bit of elbow grease working with them, but it seems like it's going to work.
And it's Fluent Pet. What a cool name! If you want to attempt this, Scott, we have to do a follow up. If your dog is able to do it. Play outside.
There we go.
I know. Wouldn't it be nice to have these buttons all the time?
I need them for
television
work.
Television. If you just need to, you know. Yeah. Need coffee. I need a coffee button.
Now the producers are in trouble.
Oh my gosh. Well, we're gonna squeeze in a quick break. Don't go anywhere. Lots more ahead here on Afternoon Focus.
We need a commercial button.
Welcome back. Check out this, an incredible time lapse of a border collie working hard to herd an entire flock of sheep up a hill. This is in New Zealand. Look at that. It looks so cool.
That is so cool.
It's hard to see the border collie. Like,
have you ever seen that in person? It is amazing to watch those dogs work. They are so organized. They are on top of it. They know where every one of those little sheep is at.
You're right.
It's spectacular to watch. But I've never seen it fast forward like that. That's pretty cool.
So neat. Oh, my gosh.
Well, hey, join us tomorrow for a very fun Friday with a story that shows you never too old to get a little silly.
They asked me if I'd mind going to a brewery. I said, are you kidding me? I said, I'm half Irish.
Whoa, what a teaser that was, Scotty.
I can't wait to see that tomorrow.
Oh, my gosh, I'm obsessed with this story. Yeah. It is really cute.
Yeah, it does.
Really,
that's
yeah.
That's funny. Well, that's our show for today. We want to hear from you, though.
Please send us your ideas. Go to our Facebook page. Do that. Give it a like and a share, too, please, while you're there. We'll look forward to seeing you back here tomorrow, same time, same couch.